Yesterday, over 30,000 refugees made their way into Uganda after war resumed in DRC after the government forces clashed with the M23 rebels who had been in Bunagana for 6 months. Authorities in Kisoro district are overwhelmed by the increased influx of the refugees into the country.
As we talk now, we have about 25,000 asylum seekers at Bunagana border. And more are still coming from porous border areas like Chibaya, Kanombe. It is unfortunate they have come at a time when Kisoro district is closing its refugee holding center at Kisoro town. What we have done is to take them back.
Kaberuka says authorities have opted to relocate the refugees to Bunagana markets and Bunagana primary school as they plan a way forward.
We are utilizing available government infrastructure. Take an example like Bunagana Town Council Market and Bunagana Primary School as we wait for Office of Prime Minister and UNHCR and its agencies to relocate them to gazetted settlement camp.
He adds that the earlier communication to relocate refugees from Nyakabande to Nachivale by 31st October still stands.
The policy in refugee handling, the host country has a mandate to allocate asylum seekers where to go. It is not asylum seekers to choose where they should go. In conjunction with OPM and UNHCR, they are gazetted areas for refugees and asylum seekers.
Isaac Reverend, one of the refugees, has advised the two parties to negotiate. He says they are tired of the continuous movements and disruption in settlement.
Leta ya Kongo na nabahekerane babarumvikana na birabute barangiza ikibazo k'abaturage twibonera amahoro.
Yesterday, fighting happened in Nukuru, about 4 kilometers from Rutshuru Center and National Road Number 2, which connects Rutshuru and Goma City. The fighting has forced many civilians to flee back to Ugandan side of Bunagana. Others also crossed from Chibaya to Rukundo Town Council after a heavy shelling landed at the border. By press time, fighting was still ongoing and more refugees were still fleeing to Bunagana Town Council. Report compiled by Kate Atuzarire for the news in Kisoro.